The new conditions raise complex issues regarding the operation and the management of Oceana Dunes, all of which State Parks needs to consider. I am working with the Coastal Commission executive leadership to figure out the best path forward in light of these new conditions. The Commission executive leadership understands that these are significant changes to make in a short amount of time. It's imperative that we fully consider the potential ramifications of these decisions and how best to operationalize them. With respect to our resources protection projects, operations, public safety, and public access as we proceed, the Commission executive leadership agrees that the conditions need to be better defined in light of things like the shorebird conservation programs, dust mitigation programs, and public access, which we need to continue. And these conversations are about much more than just OHV access.
And maybe to put a finer point on it, does that, because the San Luis Obispo paper has already said there's some items that they directed that are not being complied with. Do I assume that you're working with the commission staff? They haven't given you permission to do something that's not in their direction at this point, have they?
No, they haven't. I can give you a good example. The Arroyo Grande Creek crossing is a really complex operational issue on which they put forward a directive. And it is currently the only way to gain access into the Oceano Dunes SVRA. And the commission staff, executive staff agrees that this condition needs to be better defined in light of shorebird conservation programs and dust mitigation programs and the public access for camping that we still want to continue. And also the determination on OHV is 3 years out in terms of what we're supposed to end at. But right now, we need to be able to solve how we can even access the area given the directives.
And I'm sorry to just keep putting a finer point on it, but
sure.
If they're saying it needs to be better defined, does that mean that you have to comply with it until they better define it?
We're working to define it with them. I am meeting with the executive director weekly, and we've also had our staff working on the operational plans so that we can take a look at what this means in terms of public safety, resources protection, and really keeping in mind the mission of the state park system, which we need to be applying as we go forward.
In another related question, there appears to be legal action that's going to be taken against the Coastal Commission on this. What's your position on state parks being involved in any legal action?
And thank you for that critical question. As I said, as we are working with the Coastal Commission, rather, to understand these operational public access issues, any potential decisions related to the department's position on legal challenges would need to be a conversation with the administration and legal counsel. So at this point, I can't answer that question.
Okay. The issue of whether state parks complies sort of is a polar opposite if legal action is taken to fight the decision. Let's leave that and then go to the other issue that is big in Big Basin Park, which was the first non-